Hello students, welcome to my channel Agriculture Engineer Online. Let us solve a problem from GATE 2015, question number 62. So the question says, in a reciprocating type mower, the maximum inertia force of 2.2 kN along the pitman occurs at 35 degree crank angle and to 25 degree pitman angle with the horizontal plane. The crank radius is 15 mm and the equivalent mass at the crank pin is 2.5 kg. If the crank rotates at 600 rpm, the resultant force passing through the crank pin in kN will be 2.25, 2.68, 2.98 and 3.42. Options are given. Let us quickly try to solve this problem. So let us go to the cutter mower bar. So mower has a crank radius. This is the crank radius. You can see it is given 50 mm. This is the pitman L, length of L. And this is, there is a some weight at the cutter bar, that is WS plus W2, and at the crank pin, that is WC plus W1, that is the unbalanced mass. So there are two angles are given, there is pitman angle, that is, and 35 degree is the crank angle is given. So it is having a rotational speed omega, let it see. And if you see the force at the pitman, the resultant force is Fp, this one, and the horizontal component will be Fh and vertical component will be Fb at the cutter bar. So if you see, this Fp will be along the pitman at the crank pin. Let us see, this is the crank pin. The crank pin has a two force on the crank pin, there is Fr, that is the radial force on the along the radius of the crank pin, and the tangential force, that is Ft in this case, Ft and Fr, two forces will be there at the crank pin. So let us see, first of all you have to calculate the two forces, that is Fr and Ft. First Fr, in this case if you see, this is theta c and this is theta p, this is the pitman angle and crank angle, then this is the resultant will be theta c minus theta p. So this is the angle between the resultant force Fp and Fr and Ft. So resultant of Fr and Ft will be Fp, and the angle is theta c minus theta p between the Fr and Fp. So let us see, so Fr will be how much? Fr will be equal to Fp into cos theta c minus theta p. That is the this one theta c minus theta p. So the component of this Fp will be equal to Fr. Fr will be equal to Fp cos theta c minus theta p. Similarly, the Ft will be equal to Fp sin theta c minus theta p. Very simple. Now let us try to solve, calculate this same. First of all, the Fr will be equal to 2.2. 2.2 is the Fp, it's given, that is the force at the crank pin, it's given 2.2, or you can say force along the pitman, Fp is given, that is 2.2 kN in this problem. Therefore, multiplying 2.2 into sin cos 35 minus 35 is the crank angle, and pitman angle is 25 degree, it's given. So putting this, you can find out the Fr is equal to 2.167 kN. Similarly, the tangential force at the crank pin will be equal to Fp sin 35 minus 25, that is to 0.382 kN. So after finding out the Ft and Fr, so you can find out the resultant between the, first of all you have to find out the unbalanced centrifugal force, because if the mass is rotating at a angular speed of 600 in this case, so 600 rpm is given, that omega or n is given, n is given 600 rpm, so you can find out the omega. The unbalanced centrifugal force at the crank pin will be equal to, that is mass of the crank pin, that is in this case given, that is 2.5 kg. There is WC plus W1 by G into omega square R. So we can say R is the crank radius, which is given 50 millimeter in this case. So putting all the values, so 2.5 is the weight at crank pin given, the unbalanced weight, and unbalanced force Fc will be equal to 2, because omega is 2 pi n by 60. Very simple. If you know there is the radian per second, there is 2 pi. N is given, this is 600 in this case, so N, 2 pi N by 60. So square into 0.05, because it's given the R is 50 millimeter, which is equal to 0.05 meter. So converting everything, so you can calculate the unbalanced centrifugal force at crank pin, that is 493.5 Newton or 0.494 kilonewton. So once you find out the centrifugal force, unbalanced centrifugal force at the crank pin, so you can find out the total force along the radius. So there, because due to the centrifugal force, this will go to the radial way, and from the Pitman force, this Fp, the radial force is coming. This is Fp cos theta c minus theta p. So if you add this, so the total unbalanced force, the total force at the crank pin will be along the radius will be equal to Fc plus Fr. That is 2.167 we calculated for the Fr, and Fc already calculated 0.494. So therefore the total force will be equal to 2.661 kilonewton. Now the resultant force at the crank pin, that is Frc, will be equal to the radial force along the crank pin, and tangential force already calculated, that is 0.382 kilonewton at the crank pin. So therefore the resultant force will be equal to square root of 2.661 square plus 0.382 square, that will be equal to 2.688 kilonewton or 2.68 kilonewton, which is given the option in the question. So therefore the option is, the answer will be 2.688 kilonewton. Therefore this problem is solved. Hope you understand the problem. Please like and subscribe to my channel, AgriEngineering Online.